So Henry's law can be stated in other words as, at constant temperature, equilibrium pressure is equal to the product of Henry's law constant and mole fraction of the gas dissolved. So this is Henry's law. So solubility of gases in liquids depend on three factors: nature of gas, effect of temperature, effect of pressure. Nature of gas means which react with the solvent dissolve more, which cannot react with the solvent dissolve less. Effect of temperature. Here, as the dissolution of a gas is an exothermic process, decreasing temperature favors the dissolution of a gas. Similarly, effect of pressure. See how is it related to mole fraction of solute? P, that means equilibrium pressure is equal to the product of Henry's law constant and mole fraction of the gas dissolved. So here KH is Henry's law constant. KH is Henry's law constant, which depends on the nature of gas. Depends on nature of gas. What are its units? We have KH equals to P by X2. Earlier I said that mole fraction has no units, only pressure has units. So this equal to, if pressure is expressed in atmosphere, so atmosphere is the unit of KH. So units of KH are the units of P. P means pressure. KH here, mole fraction has no units, that's why. Now this KH, how does it depend on temperature? You know, KH and temperature are directly proportional. That means for any gas with increase in temperature, its KH value increases. How are solubility and KH related? Since solubility and temperature for this kind of solutions inversely proportional to temperature, therefore solubility is inversely proportional to Henry's law constant. That means if any gas has more KH, its solubility is less. If any gas is heated in a solution, its solubility decreases. So this is about solubility of gases in liquids. Now let's see the applications and limitations of Henry's law. Applications. Applications of Henry's law. First one, to increase the solubility of CO2 gas in soft drinks, they are sealed under high pressure. So to increase solubility of CO2, the bottles are sealed under high pressure. Why they are sealed under high pressure? If pressure is more, its solubility is also more. That's why to increase the solubility of a CO2, which is the application of Henry's law. Because from Henry's law we have a relation that P is equal to KH into mole fraction of the gas. So how these two are related? If pressure is increased, mole fraction also increases. That's why to increase the solubility of CO2 gas in soft drinks, they are sealed under high pressure. Soft drinks are soda water. If you take, why they are sealed under high pressure? To increase the solubility of gas. Similarly, scuba divers. Who are scuba divers? Scuba divers are, they go to deep sea for the research or to collect pearls like something. So these are scuba divers. They usually carry oxygen cylinders along with them. Their oxygen cylinders are contained with not only air, helium is also used there. Generally, oxygen cylinders for artificial respiration is nothing but nitrogen plus oxygen mixture. That is, this is normal oxygen cylinders contain N2 plus O2. whereas the cylinders which are carried by scuba divers contain the mixture of nitrogen plus oxygen plus helium. Nitrogen plus oxygen plus helium. That means the air is diluted with helium. Why it is diluted? To avoid the medical condition bends. Bends is a medical condition caused by the nitrogen gas bubbles in the blood capillaries. When a scuba diver carries this air mixture, what happens is under deep sea, at deep sea, you know, there will be very high pressure. For that high pressure, nitrogen also starts to dissolve in the blood. Generally, when we breathe, all gases we inhale, but the oxygen gas dissolves in our blood and it is transported to various tissues of our body. But nitrogen will not dissolve, it simply comes out. But under deep sea, what happens is nitrogen also starts to dissolve in the blood. Because of that, that person when comes to out of sea, that means when he comes from deep sea to earth, what happens is the dissolved nitrogen gas starts to evolve. That evolved gas forms some bubbles. Those bubbles block the blood capillaries. This leads to very severe pain. That severe pain caused by the nitrogen bubbles in the blood capillaries is called bends. To avoid the bends, this mixture, nitrogen-oxygen mixture, is diluted with helium. Diluted with helium, right? So scuba divers use this. So this is also another application of Henry's law. Similarly, mountaineers or climbers, they use air under high pressure. Under high pressure. Why do they use air under high pressure? This is 1 atmosphere pressure, but in cylinders of climbers, there will be high pressure, more than 1 atmosphere, there will be pressure. Why they carry air under high pressure? Because at high altitude, what happens is pressure decreases. That decreased pressure makes the person to become weak and to unable to think. So these conditions can be avoided using high pressure air. So that's why mountaineers or climbers, they carry this gaseous mixture, that means this air under high pressure. Okay, these three are applications of Henry's law. Next, what are its limitations? Limitations of Henry's law. First one, Henry's law is applicable at a low temperature, at a low pressure. Third factor, when there is no reaction between gas and solvent. Under these conditions only Henry's law applicable. Henry's law is applicable. Okay, this is about Henry's law.